Okay, so today, what I'm going to do or start with will be something along the state pool. So the state pools, I believe I have in here a thing that goes through maintenance for all of them. I don't really need to do that, do I? If I have, these are all based off of what? Component pool base. So rather what I can do is I can swap that out for in the main. What I'm going to try to do is try to get rid of these older struts of specifics and just base everything off of the lists of objects, pools and loaders and that I operate on. Just operate directly on those instead. So application here, find wherever we have maintenance. Here, so at this point it'll be like for auto generator. We go through the simulation set. Go through component pools, which is what this is, right? We'll run maintenance on each of them individually for the moment. Okay, this requires me to go to the component pool base and have a virtual do that, right? Now this, does this work? Does the template, yeah, the templated version of the maintenance function should be fine. Yeah. Should be, being the interesting word there. And then we'd have to not run it through there. Maybe not. Oh, yes, change that back up to that from last time. Unimplemented pure virtual method maintenance in that. Because it's the data pool is not based off of this. Okay. Well, that's a very early stumbling block for this one, for sure. Component pool base, this maintenance. Not great. Not great. See, this does have void maintenance, but this is not from the same inheritance hierarchy. So this is not considered to be the implementation of that. Unless what I could do, okay, that would be interesting. I'm not sure why it's complaining about this right now. Why? Why are you complaining about this? Oh, right, because they're not implemented. Yes. So starting on the first one, which one's the first one it's complaining about? Armature state pool. Let's try armature. Close that up. That and this. Go to full resource. Armature state pool. Sorry, not this one. It's the component pool. You. Right here. What I can do is say void maintenance. Override goes into this, so that could work. That'll clear. Okay, so that'll clear that. Not great. Whatever, I'll get. But I'd rather do this than something even more arbitrary and crazy. We got that. We need to go to position. There you are. That leaves the private member. Okay. It's not really great. Position, go to camera. That leaves rigid body from physics. Okay. So at this point, I can do this. You have some odd business with the image loader. Right, because, yeah, that's still going. But okay. That just broke because of issue. That one falls. Okay. Okay, now it's falling again. Whatever. So at this point, that's gone. I can now get rid of the state pool entirely. Like, this just disappears. Poof. Simulation set is reduced. So now it's just fully dynamic components. Which means I can add and remove arbitrary components from binaries at any time. Which is a step forward. Do 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 do. Almost. Almost. If I want to remove these pools, actually. Okay, first of all, but, okay, we can get rid of this. Right. This function is gone. So we're a step closer. What if I have a registration system or pattern, much like I do for the importers, but that's the same kind of deal for the components? So, okay. What I would do, okay, for the moment, what I can do is I'll have, like, you know, not that. I just say, hey, I have a new just need one of those, okay? New position 3D pool, new camera pool. Right now, if I delete one of these things and I lose, then these are pointers that just go off into nowhere. So that's not great. Actually, that's something I should probably check before I do anything here. Is, do I have any leak memory issues? Ooh, okay. Where to go? Do I have any fundamental things when I launch this? Do I have, I just have width and height. That's it. Okay. So when it's done, I can actually just run it without issue, preferably. Or rather, Build follow engine. There we go. Yeah. Okay, outside, outside, outside. This is something that I'm not cleaning out properly. To do with the pipeline creation, it looks like. The importation of what? YAML read material definition. I'm reading this. I'm not properly deleting these things. That's unfortunate. What about this? The file importer. Okay. So that's a lot of stuff I can actually live with. So for the moment, I can work with those issues. So I'll get rid of that. We're actually pretty clear on that. Clear enough for me to move forward. So what was it doing here? Yes. Do. Do this. This is going nowhere. Probably because I'm going to bet. This isn't even inside of that. Right. Yes. I have a number of things still attached to that. Git resource pool, which is the type, which takes in what? Void star. Now, right now, it's still based off, this still is still based off of that. This goes through. little helper there, another helper here for retrieving resource pool. In this case, it'll be resource loader. Whoops. No, this is still has full resource loader base. This is a pointer to pointers. Effectively the same, except we're going through component pool, base things. Turn that, get component pool. Still a very messy application, but it's getting there. So much foundational stuff I still have to do. Thing to time. P resource pools, so these aren't resource pools, these are component pools now. Okay, at this point we can, our component pool is what I'm looking for specifically, so dot state, or sorry, state dot, yeah, okay. Simulation set, get component pools of data. Okay. First, sorry, what? First argument. Ah, yes. That. So now it becomes this. Wait a second. Whoops. This becomes position 3D pool instead. Correct? So we had a real that and we got a real that, so we can actually continue now, right? Or not. Because of the of that bug, which I still don't want to deal with quite yet. I can't really remake the resource loading mechanism until I can figure out how it's going to work with the new loaders, or how to disentangle the loaders from everything, from being required as if I, because I still want to load directly from resources. I could just have resource load, but I don't want to have to give the loader to the resource. Yeah, and that's what this entire disentanglement of everything else is about, still. Okay, where was I? So we've got state dot something next, right about there. This, I got it here, and we got it here. That's good. Okay. And here we got state dot. Okay, we can at least pass that into there. That's a pointer for that. Not quite for position though. Did I get the wrong thing? Position 3D pool. No, that's is that just Clang D being a little behind? Nope, nope, it's still gonna have a problem with that. Position 3D pool, that's what this one is. Oh no, that's not what this one is. That probably explains it, wouldn't it? Get out of here. There we go. Okay, that's one. And then we got another one for. that in. Okay. State cam. Yes, I've got to fix that as well, the XR stuff. Hilarious. Okay. Position, armature, render state. And all that fantastic stuff. Inset swap chain. I'm going about this the wrong way. Aren't I? Yes, yes I am. Or yeah. Okay. I'm going about it kind of the right way, but also somewhat the wrong way. So that's fine. This'll be fine. This'll be fine. This'll be fine. So it's mostly the stuff in the application that I need to be bothered about. This is fine, this is fine, this is fine. Application has a bit that's new. Okay, this is nice. This I'll probably keep. There's another section down here. This I'm keeping. Otherwise, the rest I'm dropping. Okay. Okay, we're at a good point here. I'm going to slightly change up what I'm doing for these other things. So, the first one I'm interested in is the system for physics. Since that's using a number of items, that's using a loader, a pool, and sorry, resource, and two component pools. Right now, I'm passing everything in every single time. That's kind of redundant. Don't really need to do that. I mean, it's fine to pass things in if I know where they are in memory all the time, kind of. But realistically, I'm going to want to change this into a more proper system to keep things keep track of some things. So, especially since, and yeah, try to establish a good pattern that I can also use on the other objects, such as visual items. Okay. So, what am I talking about? This will be like the first real system, so do I need a base class? I don't, maybe later. Oh, the physics system, whatever. Public. Like that. We'll have pointers to some items. I will not. I mean, I could try to construct these things. don't know either. I'm really. No. So what do I need when I'm running this? I mean, I'd already have, what is this, init physics. This is like a generic thing for what? Setting the gravity. Okay. Realistically, each system will have a system per simulation. So this is already absolutely garbage and terrible. No, don't want that. We have resources. We have two resources that we use, which are so we have this and this. For some reason, I don't know if I forget why we have the loader. We do. Why do we have the loader? Collision shape pool star P or realistically. Oh, that'll also be a part of it, yeah. World instance items, which is the this. Basically these, down to that. If I want to do this, I need to have all of these things up top. Who's got it? Do you have it? You got it. Here we go, the C++ nonsense of let's include everything to make things work. I mean, that is why I'm getting so many calls to load it, is because it's still not here, so I try to reload it over and over and over again. If it's not in the loaded state and it's not f and it failed, otherwise it may be in the loading state. So that's why we're getting so many calls. Really, but it's a good example of how like this is a case that should be handled not really from here, but from the actual loading process. Should be able to handle the case of requesting a load every time and this. Okay, I do need to have a constructor for the moment. And presumably a destructor as well. So I need that as well. So I'll have to kind of put this in a like system two. Otherwise it'll be a little bit too much cross stuff going on. Do I need a destructor? I don't know yet. Probably do. I will at least need the thing that I'm on here. So I need to with the float of time past. Okay. P broad phase. Yeah, I should really do this like MP member pointer. Maybe that member pointer. MP collision dispatcher, MP solver. MP world. So we've got MP broad phase, MP collision, that. Then we got this. Then we got this. And then finally we got this. Not exactly sure what I'm going to have to do here quite yet. I'm sure it'll be interesting. We'll be forced to deinitialize. Close up. Anyways. Uh, Clang D decided to break, so we'll restart that. Okay, we're back. Some things I need to do. I need to have like an initialize and deinitialize, but not quite yet. Add object, remove object. Okay, those are basically the exact same things. I need this. Physics world. Okay, I just need all these. Waiting resources. Again, I need to put more, to front load more and more of this stuff. Okay. Let's say, let me, okay, let me, let's say I do front load these things. So I have void add object. That and that. So this is what? The body pool, the entity. Wait, hold on. Okay, yeah, that. Okay, let's take this out. We go all the way down here. Amazing, we get rid of these. It becomes a part of that system now. So instead of that, it becomes P rigid. MP. Okay. P collision. If it doesn't exist, then I need to add it. That's why I have. Oh, that's why I have the loader. That's why I have the loader. And because of my stupid tying of it all together. Yes. Dang. How foolish I was. MP collision. Collision shape loader. Star. Go. Time to get rid of that eventually. Okay. That's looking quite okay. So now we go back to doing the processing, which is pretty light otherwise. Basically, same as this. Don't need these three. Or four, sorry. Blam. Okay. Replace or add that. Are we exporting any of that? We need to export that, and that. Yes, that does not need to be exported. System 2. Okay, moving back to this. That should mean, okay, so we have, wait, hold on. There's actually one more thing I need, is to do the init physics. This. Need to do that in the constructor, just after. Word. Then, now we need to go into application. We need to, oh, no, not here. We need to go into the simulation set. We need to add this system. I don't have a system thing, so components, we'll just kind of say it's a system. System. We'll just have to for the moment. While I'm trying to get this up and running. Wonderful. This will be basically converted to something like this as well. Some kind of systems processing something or other. Yeah. What was I going to do? It's created here. Then, but I don't have anything. I need to like initialize it. So what initialize will bring in will just be these four items. So basically these. And at that point, when it's initialized, then it'll take in the state of all these, do any processing that needs to be done, like heavy duty processing, like going scanning every single current entity that's currently in the system. And then, so that'll be much heavier. Then after that point, it can do the more like delta-based processing where it just checks like those that were added or removed or updated specifically. So that I don't have to have necessarily going through everything all the time. Every time, anyways. Because right now, right now it is going based on insertions and that, but this is relying on the fact that I'm not running maintenance between the time I add the object into the pool and by the time I first call the processing. I don't have that guarantee in a better system where I may when I'm loading objects in, I may need to run processing several times to compact it into something or other, or I don't know, other processing, who knows? But I should really have like the initialization, deinitialization be set definitely a clear separate stage in the life cycle of this system. Be different from processing, which means I need to export them, and then they're before processing. First, we set these. And then eventually this will be converted to taking in the void start pointers of like the loaders and that, and then it'll grab out what it can, and then it'll return an error code if it can't find what it needs. So this is primarily based on the rigid body pool, if I recall correctly. And that really is the primary of this. So we just go through the rigid body and we just try to add them. And that's it. Rigid body is this. Then we can rely on that stuff to. So not in begin, but just begin and. Yeah, I don't even need these. I could just do this. And. Do that. Something here. We got to do it for both removed and regular. Something for RM. Just in case we're not processing this one for some reason at that time. And then we gotta clear out these things. So MP position equals null pointer, just to kind of. Really, realistically, like this shouldn't even be required. I mean, it'll be discarded at this point. Don't care. Don't need to care. Don't need to care. Okay. Going back to application, we're going to now have down in somewhere where we do setting up of things somewhere in the initialization. here, close to here. Pool, descriptor pool, here we go, animation pool, okay. No. I have those other functions for a reason. So what I'm going to, dang it. Application first. Make the engine more dynamic. Meaning direct, available. All right, this is just that part. That's perfect. Put that in. Great. We are here again. Application. What was I doing? I was going to do something right about here. Yes. So I was going to use the new frickin' type. So. This actually makes it a bit easier to move things around as well. Okay, collision. Okay, so what's wrong with you? Sorry. Sorry, what is this? No viable conversion from collision shape loader to that. It's supposed to be a pointer. Yeah, you return pointers, right? No, yes. Nope. Fix up that. Okay, back on this. Great. System two, we initialize. And then down here somewhere we'll have a physics processing. Right about here, we're going to go instead, it'll be a T simulation set physics system dot process. Elapsed in seconds. That. That removes that. And we gotta get rid of init physics. And that also means now on the way out, then the deinitialize somewhere. Right about here, resource unloading. So before we do this, this point will be like, you know, it'll be physics system dot deinitialize. Technically, I should also probably create and remove the world at that stage as well, but I'm really. Physics world and those other collision items for bullet physics. I have larger plans for those. Not just have a one world per simulation, there'll be multiple. But for the moment they'll stay here. Keep them somewhat simple. Well, that works. Huzzah, huzzah. Still fairly light on the includes as well. Got rid of that. We can trash this file now. We can actually just, okay, first of all, just not compile it. How that works. Works fine. And then we can do that. Delete that. This will be replacing the old one once it's finished thinking it over. Thank you. So this is a much better pattern to my mind, and probably should be the thing I use on moving forward. This is still not too bad. It's 250 lines, so it's quite acceptable. Quite acceptable, not overly crazy. Adding and moving. That is okay. So let's put the physics system. Not quite yet. I mean, this is increasing it from 230 to 250. Yeah, it's like nothing. Does this even require full physics? No. We've got that. There you are. Not entirely sure on where I should actually do the, like, when I'm passing in these pointers, do I do the processing like outside and pass these specific ones in that I know about, or do I pass in the void lists to here and have this process and figure out which ones it needs? Because depending on which way I go, like, is it better to have more information up front or less? Like, how. You know, I'll leave it for now, like this. This is an acceptable medium for now. But there's always more and more thoughts to have on how things should probably work. How big is this file? 1500. A lot of it's still blanked out XR stuff that I have to still deal with. The function oh, that's something I'd have to do. I would need to clear out on deinitialize, I need to remove. That doesn't matter anymore. And I probably should do it here anyways. Nice. So now I'd have to do something similar for, let's see, I got that camera, render state, armature states, maybe. Let's see, armature states, animation processing. This is based on these. This doesn't really have the same kind of deal going on because these don't really rely on any external data currently. I could just do standalone functions as they are right now, but what's probably going to happen is much like the others, there'll be eventually a vector of like system bases. And I'd rather have like this, like the armature state pool. Wait. What? Armature pool? Oh yeah, the armature, the resource pool, and the component pool in a point in a struct somewhere else that I can just then just point to and say process, giving it the time as well since last. Maybe. Maybe. An hour and a half. Okay, I've got to grab a quick drink. BRB. Okay, and back. Right, armature stuff, armature system. Armature animation. I mean, is it really animation? Or is it just armature processing? I want to call it more armature processing. Armature system. That's what I'm going to call it. Over here, animation processing that. The two classes we're going to for declare. So that's that. We don't have anything for that or that. We do have void processing, or just process. And we have void initialize. We're taking these two. That one first, and then this one. Initialize, deinitialize. Processing don't really require a constructor or destructor. They just don't matter. I don't really see this. Actually. Maybe. Maybe. No, for the moment, yeah, just keep it simple. animation processing, move this over. We need these two. We need this. Some generic stuff here, but what really matters is down here, it's a void. Animation, armature state, wait. Armature system, there we go. We gotta go down to state pools, add it here. Not here, simulation set, here. Okay, going back here, back here. So physics, processing, initialization is here. Get resource pool for that. I'd also want the loader, wouldn't I? Yeah, I would. Okay, first of all, okay, then we got, where's the armature stuff? The armature stuff will be in here somewhere. It's animation. This is the graphic stuff, so we've got to, here we go, processing armature states. Okay, that was initialization. Do it the opposite way for deinitialization. there. Not that it does anything yet, but I'm sure it will in due time. Here I am. Okay. Actually, what I want to do, leave that there as it is. Don't process physics. I just actually want to see. Animation's still happening, right? Yes, it is. Okay. So I can get rid of that. Which means I can clear out that. Animation processing. Like that. These two go away. Animation processing, that goes away as well. Now, something I'd be interested in is actually doing this in line. So, P data time. Plus that instead on the new armature system CPP, so we can go here. Say, hey, you know, P armature state time plus equals time elapsed or time. Sorry, what's it called? Time passed. That should mean we don't need this anymore. Do it inline as we're processing it. Yep. What did I change here? Okay. Physics F, fix up, animation, animation, armature. What is this doing? No, that's not that. Armature, armature, that, that, that. These show up as renames. This is changing, so we add that. Down, armature. Going down, armature again. No, but this one, yes. Forms the and follows the okay. I need to add to do so tracking to armature components. So that's actually something I probably should do. Which is, if I close these guys up, armature state currently is this. It has an armature ID, but it doesn't have a direct pointer. And similar for the animation. No, the animations are tied in the armature. But still, if I can have a direct link to the armature ID, to the actual armature, since resources are static in memory after they're created. So I don't, if I have a link to it somewhere in here that I don't copy over on a new system, then the armature system during initialization and passing through, if it can't find this, then it'll add a direct pointer, it'll add it to an awaiting list or something like that, so that I don't have to search for it every single time if I don't have to. But that's later. Okay, so this is the three. This is the animation stuff for the component maintenance for component pools, which I'm thinking I'll probably do right. Oh crap! I didn't. I should fix up. Starting really low on stuff. Changes that up. Okay. out that. These two don't need. Discard those. Okay, it's basically coming up to 2 hours, so I'm gonna pull the call on this one. But I need to get these guys. Six. Need to fix that up. Fix that up. A little bit easier. Wonderful. Okay. This is all part of the idea for getting rid of state dot. So we've got left. Camera position. Okay, not really, can't really do much about that one. Or this one. Camera system, position, animation. Okay, so these three are heavily based on working together with Vulkan, which does, and they're already part of systems. I just need to refine those systems, update them a little bit. Okay. What about, yeah, that's updating. That's a separate thing, okay. Separate. Separate again. Camera again. This is very special. Okay. So I'll do something for this auto. But this is position, right? Yeah. This is the thing I had earlier. Get component pool for position 3D pool. Okay, make sure those are still the same. Okay. It actually runs, right? Yes. Okay. Now, position descriptor pool, the animation pool, and the other one, camera. I'll do these tomorrow. I think I've got a little bit enough for tonight. You know what? No. If I don't do it now, I'll basically, I mean, for now, what I'm going to do is I'm going to move these around. So it'll be part of the initialization, I think. Would I? This is actually, Actually, this requires quite a number of changes. Upload bone offsets. Should be kind of done regardless of, like, where is this actually happening? Okay, no, this is in a, this is happening in the right place. Oh yeah, I also need to, Okay. VK animation pool is initialized where exactly? It's deinitial. Okay, it's deinitialized there. After I do all this stuff, I'm ending the session. XR set. Okay. And then up here will be the initialization. So I initialize it before these other systems. Okay, so I can probably work with this. VK animation. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to change this up so that these mesh pool, these guys are brought in via this. So this could just be the frame index. That's all it needs. This is all public right now. Great. These are all components. Render state, armature pool. No, these are resources, so they need to be reordered a little bit. That. So we got the update. Da, da, da. Okay, clear these out of here. We gotta do this. MP. And then in application, gonna have to change this up. These guys are all going away. To be replaced up here with a number of these. So we got our pool, resource pool, a couple component pools. Okay, armature pool, yes, mesh pool. Armature pool, render state pool. I need to stop the physics. So I can actually watch the simulation, the armature animation happen in real time. So these ones are ready. Position descriptor pool. Okay, two more. Oops. 2 on the camera system, position 3D, and camera pool. Don't need that or these anymore. It's just okay, we've got a render state thing here. What are the last remaining states? Oops. 13. 1, 2, 3. Position, position. Positions, render state. Position, position. Okay. Realistically, I should also move the rendering into a system. Get it out of here. But before I do that, I really want to get XR back up and running, so I have the entropy of both systems to compare and iterate on together. Rather than just doing one and then just being completely divergent between two. They need to be somewhat kept close together. So at least I'll get rid of the rest of the state things then. I'll do that at least. Position. Position here as well. Is that really it? Just the last ones are inside the XR. Three, four. Okay. So then at this point, I should actually be able to just rip out state pools entirely. The simulation set. as long as I'm going to change these up to be like new that, yeah. You know what? No, I'll do that next time. Leave that as is. Just get rid of these guys. Okay. Git log. That's good, 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 good. Okay, and then I'll call that there for the night. Cheers.